Good morning everyone. Today I am going to teach you third chapter of your English book. The name of this chapter is Taro's Reward. This is the story of a young man whose name is Taro. He was a thoughtful son who wanted to fulfill all the wishes of his parents. Let us begin the chapter. A young woodcutter named Taro lived with his mother and father on a lonely hillside. A young woodcutter whose name is Taro, who lived with his mother and father on a hilly area. It means all around his hut there was hills and the mountains. All day long he chopped wood in the forest. Chopped means cutting the wood into pieces. So all day, which work he used to do? He used to cut the wood in the forest and he sell it. Though he worked very hard. He used to work very hard, but he earned very little money. We cannot earn lot of money by cutting and selling the wood in the market. This made him very sad. He was a thoughtful son. He wanted to give his old parents everything what they needed. As I have already told you, he was a thoughtful son who wanted to give all the things what their parents needed. He wanted to give him all the things to them. One evening when Taro and his parents were sitting in a corner of their hut, one day all three of them were sitting in a corner, a strong wind began to blow. It means it was too air. It was too airy day, so they feel very cold. They are telling about the cold season, and the strong winds is blowing. It whistled through the cracks of the hut. There were some cracks and the holes in the hut, and from these cracks and the holes they are getting very cold air. So they started shivering. Suddenly Taro's father said, as they were feeling very cold, his father said, "I wish I had a cup of sake." In this line he is telling about the Japanese sake who used to warm the body. A Japanese sake, it is very expensive, and by drinking that we can warm up our body. So his father is wishing to have a cup of this sake. It would warm me and do my old heart good. By drinking that sake, I can warm my body and my heart also become very good, because he wish to drink it. This made Taro sadder than ever. After hearing the wish of his father, he became more sadder, because this sake is very expensive, and he started to think, how can I earn more money? He asked himself, how do I get a little sake for my poor old father? He wanted to give this sake to his father. So he became more sadder and he decided to work harder than the before. He thought that next morning I will do hard work. Maybe I can get this sake to my father. Next morning Taro jumped out of bed earlier than the usual. It means next morning he get up earlier than the last day, and he started to cutting the tree. That day he cut more trees. He cut and chopped, and soon he was so warm. It means when we used to do hard work, our body felt sweat and we became warm. We can warm up our body by the hard work. So he was doing the hard work for cutting the tree, and he became sweaty. His body become wet with the sweat. So he had to take off his jacket because he was feeling so warm. It was too hot, too sunny day. That's why he had to take off his jacket. His mouth was dry. He was thirsty. He wanted to drink water. My poor old father, he thought, if only he was as warm as his body is wet with the sweat. He was thinking about his father. Maybe his father also can feel warm, this much warm in the cold season. And with that he began to chop even faster, and by thinking that he started to chop more faster than the before. thinking of the extra money, because he was thinking about to earn the extra money. He was thinking that he could get a cup of sake for his father. So for thinking this, he is doing harder and harder work than the before. Then suddenly Taro stopped chopping. What was that sound he heard? He heard a sound and he stopped to chopping the tree. Could it be? He was thinking in his own mind, is it possible? Because he was hearing a sound of running water. Before that also he used to go that place, but he could never heard such kind of sound. Taro could not remember that he heard such kind of sound. So he followed this sound of the rushing water. So what he found, just behind a hill, just behind a rock, there was a waterfall. Kneeling at the place where the waterfall flowed quietly. So he reached there and he sat on that place to taste this water, because he was so thirsty also. So he make his hand like a cup and little water he tasted. He put the water into his lips and after tasted it, he was asking himself a question, was it water? Because he feel the taste is a little bit changed. Or was it a sake? Because he tasted it and he feel it is sake. He tasted it again and again, twice or thrice he tasted it, but what he feel, it was a delicious sake. Instead of cold water, it was not just a water, it was the sake. Taro quickly filled the pitcher he had with him and hurried home. Taro had a bottle with him because he used to keep it for drinking the water. Taro filled this pitcher with the sake and he hurried to the home. He started to run towards the home because he want to give this sake to his old father. Old man delighted with the sake. After only one swallow of the liquid, he stopped shivering and did a little dance in the middle of the floor. As his father taste this one swallow of this liquid, he stopped shivering. Before tasted that shake, he was feeling so cold. As he tasted the one swallow, he stopped shivering and did a little dance in the middle of the floor. He became very happy to taste this sake. That afternoon, a neighbor stopped by for a visit. Next afternoon, one of the lady was passing from their hut. She was visiting from there nearby, and Taro's father politely offered her a cup of the sake. Taro's father offered the lady to taste this sake. The old lady drank it greedily and thanked the old man. The lady tasted it and she said thank you to the old man for this sake. Then Taro told her the story of the magical waterfall. Taro told how he got that shake, that magical waterfall in which we can get the shake. Thanking them for the delicious drink, he left a hurry. After hearing the story of that magical waterfall, the lady said thank you to both of them, and he left in a hurry. By nightfall, she said she had spread the story throughout the whole village. And this night, he spread this story of the magic fall to all the villagers. He told about this magical waterfall to all the neighbors and all the people, those who are living in the village. That evening, there was a long procession of visitors to the woodcutter. And everybody, as he heard the story of the magical waterfall, they are not able to believe themselves. So they came one by one. All of the villagers came one by one to the woodcutter's house because they want to taste the sake. Each man heard the story and took a sip of sake. They tasted the sake. In less than an hour, the pitcher was empty. It was not completed 1 hour and the pitcher became empty. There was no sake left in the pitcher. Next morning, Taro started for work even earlier than the morning before. Next morning, Taro started his journey for cutting the wood earlier than the before. He carried with him the largest pitcher he owned. And at their home, which was the largest pitcher he carried with him, because he want to fulfill this pitcher with the sake. For he instead first of all to go to the waterfall. So first of all he visited to the waterfall. But before reached to the waterfall, what he found? He found to his great surprise all his neighbors there. What he saw? All of their neighbors were there. When he reached it, he found to his great surprise all of his neighbor were there, and they were carrying pitcher, jars, buckets, many of the utensils they carried with them, because they want to fulfill these utensils with the magic sake. The Taro did not reach near the villagers. He was looking towards them from behind the rock. Anything they could find to hold the magic sake. Then one villager knelt and held his mouth under the waterfall to drink. One of the villager, he come near the waterfall and he tasted it. What he tasted? He drank it and he said, it's water. He drank it again and again and then shouted angrily, water, nothing but water. That neighbor tasted the water again and again, and after tasting it he said, it's just a water, nothing it is. We have been tricked. The Taro played a trick with them. He shouted and he told to the all of the villagers that Taro played a trick with us. It is just a water, it's not the sake. Where is Taro? He shouted in the angry mode and he said, let us drown him in this waterfall. We will drown Taro in this waterfall only. But Taro had been wise enough. But Taro was wise, intelligent boy. To slip behind a rock, he hid himself behind the rock. When he saw how things were going, when he saw that they are in angry mode and they are getting only just water from that spring, so he did not come out. He hid himself just behind the rock. He was now where to be found. The villagers cannot found him. Muttering their anger and disappointment, they were very angry. The villagers were very angry with Taro and they got the disappointment. It means they came to get the sake, but they cannot get the sake because they got just water is there. So they were very much disappointed. The villager left the place one by one. One by one they tasted it and they left this place. Taro came out from the hiding place. When all of the villagers went from that place, then Taro came out and he was asking a question himself. Was it true? He wondered, because he has taken the water from this only and he tasted it and he felt that it is sake. So how can it be possible? Yesterday I got sake from this spring and today it converted into water. How it can happen? Was the sake is my dream? So he was thinking that can it possible that it was my dream only, that I got the sake from this spring? Once more he caught a little liquid in his hand. He also reached near that spring and again he tasted and put it to his lips. It was the same fine shake. What he tasted yesterday, it was the shake only. To the thoughtful son, the magic waterfall gave the delicious shake, because that boy is thinking about the shake only. That's why this magical spring is giving the delicious shake to Taro. It gave, and the other persons, those who are not so thoughtful and they were not honest, they don't want to serve of their parents, for the other people it was just water only. The story of Taro and his magic waterfall reached the emperor of Japan. Somebody told this story to the king of Japan. He sent for the young woodcutter and rewarded him with 20 pieces of gold as द किंग हर्ड द स्टोरी ऑफ तारो ही सेंड रिवार्ड टू तारो ऑफ 20 गोल्ड पीसेस गोल्ड कॉइन्स फॉर हैविंग बीन सो गुड एंड काइंड बिकॉज ही वॉज सो गुड एंड काइंड मैन देन ही नेम्ड द मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल फाउंटेन इन द सिटी आफ्टर तारो दिस वाटरफॉल नेम बिकेम ऑन द नेम ऑफ तारो एंड इट became the most beautiful fountain in the city. This said the emperor was to encourage all children to honor and obey their parents. And after this story, the king also said to the children that they should honor their parents and they should obey their parents. We should always respect our elders and our parents. If we help the older peoples and respect and honor the older ones, then definitely we also will be rewarded for that. Thank you. Have a nice day. Learn this story by your own and try to understand it. Have a wonderful day ahead.